her stubborn and harsh instead of obedient like she should be. And my gracious, if she won't agree to her entreaties right now, I ask you to let me exercise the right that all mothers have happened. Since she belongs to me, I can do what I want with her. As the law says, I can either make her marry Demetrius or have her killed.
What do you have to say for yourself, beautiful Hermia? Think carefully, pretty girl. You should think of your father as a god, since he is the one who gave you your beauty. To him, you are like a figure that he has sculpted out of wax, and he has the power to either disfigure it or keep it intact. Demetrius is an admirable man.
So is Lysander.
You're right, Lysander's admirable too. But since your father does not wish him to marry you, you must consider Demetrius to be the better man.
Please forgive me, Your Grace. I don't think speaking my mind to such a powerful and known person as yourself will damage my reputation for modesty. But please, tell me the worst thing that will happen to me if I refuse to marry you.
You'll either be executed or you'll never see another man again. So think carefully about what you want, pretty girl. Consider your age and question your feelings. Then decide whether you could stand to be a nun. Wearing a priestess's habit, caged up in a cloister forever, living your entire life without a husband or children, weakly chanting hymns to the cold and virginal goddess of the moon. People who can restrain their passions and stay virgins forever are holy. But although a virgin may be rewarded in heaven, a married woman is much happier on earth. A married woman is like a rose who is picked and made into a beautiful perfume. Well, a virgin priestess just withers away on a stem.
Well, I'd rather wither away than give up my virginity to someone I don't know.
Take some time to think about it. By the time of the next new moon, the day Hippolyta and I shall be married. Be prepared either to be executed for disobeying your father, to marry Demetrius as your father wishes, or to take a vow to spend the rest of your life as the virgin priestess of the moon goddess.
Please, give in, sweet Hermia. And Lysander, stop acting like she's yours. I've got more of a right to her than you do.
You have her father's love, Demetrius. So why don't you marry him and leave me?
It's true, Lysander. He has my love. That's why I'm giving Hermia to Demetrius. She's mine, and I'm giving her to him.
My lord, I am just as rich and just as noble as he is. My prospects are just as good, if not better than his. I love Hermia more than he does. And most importantly of all, beautiful Hermia loves me, which is more important than all those other things I am bragging about. Demetrius, and I will say this to his face, courted Nadir's daughter, Helena, caused her to fall in love with him. She devoutly loves this most horrid and unfaithful man.
I must confess that I have heard so much, and I meant to ask Demetrius about it myself. But I was busy with personal matters, and it must have slipped my mind. Anyway, Demetrius and Aegeus, both of you, come with me. I want to speak to you in private. As for you, beautiful Hermia, prepare to do as your father wishes, because otherwise the law says you must die or become a nun, and there's nothing that I can do about that. Come, Hippolyta. How are you, my love? Demetrius and Aegeus, come with us. I have a few things I want you to do for our wedding, and then I also want to discuss something with you that